I'm Michael Padgett. I'm the curator of ancient art at the Princeton University Art Museum, and I'm here with Lisa Arcamano and Leslie Gat and her team of conservators to conserve and remove an ancient Roman mosaic pavement from Antioch-on the Orontes in what was ancient Syria and is today Turkey. It was excavated by Princeton archaeologists in the 1930s. Antioch was one of the great cities of the ancient world. It was founded in 302 by Seleucus I Nicator. The pavement is installed in the vestibule of the architecture laboratory of the School of Architecture at Princeton University, where it has been since 1949, when it was installed here as part of the renovation of this building by Princeton architect and professor of archaeology Jean Labattu. And it has been here ever since. And because of that and its exposure to the elements, it's now in poor shape. But by the time Leslie and her team are through with it, they will have consolidated it and cleaned it and partially restored it, and the original bright colors of the stone tesserae, the little squares of stone that were used to make the mosaic, will have something of their former vibrancy. There's an incredible number of colors in these mosaics. When they didn't have the color they exactly wanted, they would use glass, or in this case, red terracotta, to get the hue they wanted. Very fine gradations. You need only stand back as you do from an impressionist painting to get the entire effect of the design. This panel was part of a border of a larger panel about 3 meters square. It's from the bottom of it. And there originally were 8 heads, 4 in the corners and then 4 on each side. The heads in the corners are female, and we think they're masks, possibly of maenads, who were the intoxicated, frenzied followers of the god Dionysus, the wine god. The date of this one has been, it's been dated everywhere from the 3rd century to AD 400, so I'm thinking that a date in the 300s is likely. Princeton joined Dumbarton Oaks and the National Museums of France, the Worcester Art Museum, the Baltimore Museum of Art, and the Fog Art Museum at Harvard to excavate it under the direction of Professor Rufus Maury. There are still excavations taking place there today, and we are in fact engaged now in a study of the Antioch material in the museum, small finds, the pottery lamps, the fragmentary sculptures, jewelry, and so on, that also came here as part of the division of finds from the 1930s, to make them more available to scholars and students around the world and to make Princeton a center of Antioch studies.
The Antioch mosaics, when they were in Turkey, when they were found, were lifted from the ground and placed onto slabs of cement so that they were backed. They came out of the original ground they were in their rug shape, and they were supported with cement and rebar. And what we're doing here is trying to lift this out of the ground without causing further damage so that we can conserve it in the conservation studio.
Once the concrete curb was removed, we revealed that the mosaic was about 2.5 inches thick. We proceeded to remove the sides of the concrete alongside the mosaic with chisels. We installed the steel slides and a Teflon sheet to slide the mosaic down onto the pallet. It was then strapped down for removal.
Over time, the rebar inside the cement has corroded and expanded and destroyed the cement and caused great damage to many of the tessera rugs. So wherever the rebar expanded, it basically, the rust caused the breakdown of the cement backing, expanded and knocked these tessera off. When the piece was in the ground, areas that were actively lifting were repeatedly coated with cement. Unfortunately, it left many areas of very, very tough concrete throughout that were covering areas of tessera. This raised piece of cement, this cement area here, this sort of cement, it was just swathed over the surface and it was just used to cover any area that was lifting. This is much too hard. Any attempt to remove this only damages and destroys the tesseras below. So we've left that. In other areas, we have removed as much of the cement as possible. Our way of dealing with it was to remove areas that we could safely, and that was fun because in many places we actually found tessera underneath it. One of the great challenges for conservators is making fills that are large and flat. And one of our ways of doing that is we put flat pieces, precast flat pieces of plaster into the center of the fill, which acts as a guide for us. We've lost many areas. We were able to save a couple of them. When you look at it, when it's finished, you should see the mosaic before you see any of the fills. Thank you.